There were a lot of features that we expected on the Lectric XP 4, but there were plenty of surprises as well. One that stands out, especially on an e-bike for $999, is the new 3.5-inch TFT display. Let me walk you through all the user-friendly features. I'll walk through all the advanced settings and what they all mean. And if you're new to electric bikes, I'll highlight a few of these settings that you might want to change to make it a little bit more accessible. And at the end of the video, I'll talk about some of the lesser known or hidden features that you might not know about, and I'll highlight what I'm calling this bike's party trick. Be sure to check out our detailed full-length review if you want to know everything about the XP4. And if you're planning to buy an electric e-bike, why not support us for free? Just click the link down in the description or scan the QR code on your screen before you make your purchase. Thank you so much for your support. Let's get started. So first off, you have the usual battery bars, but now a percentage, which is nice. When you're riding, you'll see a wattage output reading. Current speed is in the middle of the screen and it's nice and large so you can read it. And below that, you can get a quick look at your trip max speed and trip average speed by holding the power button and pedal assist up at the same time. Instead of the traditional pedal assist levels 1 through 5, now they have names. So you have Eco, Tour, Sport, Sport Plus, and Turbo, the highest level of pedal assist. Lights can be turned on by holding pedal assist up, and yes, now we have turn signals. Simply press the turn signal again to turn it off, though yes, it will turn off after about 20 seconds. And for the first time, we have hazard lights. Simply press both the left and right turn signal at the same time. Walk mode can be engaged by holding pedal assist down, and you can hit the power button to get additional information. And by the way, it still will list the current speed as well as your current pedal assist level. Love that touch. So on the first screen, we have cadence, trip time, trip distance, as well as the odometer. And I personally have been loving that the trip resets when you turn off the bike. Hitting the power button again reveals additional information. This includes input power, that's the power you're putting into the bike, motor power, as well as amps and voltage. Holding pedal assist up and down at the same time gets you into the advanced settings, and oh my gosh, this is just so much more user-friendly. Instead of the P settings, let me know in the comment section if you know what I'm talking about when I say P settings. So here you have screen brightness and sleep. Sleep changes the amount of time until the bike automatically turns off if you're not using it. Then you have distance units as well as tire size. Next you have bike classification, and it's not just 3 settings, there's 4. So you have class 1, top speed of 20 miles per hour, that will disable the throttle, pedal assist up to 20 miles per hour. Then you have class 2, that's going to allow you to use the throttle up to 20 miles per hour. And then you have class 3, that's really a mix of class 2 and class 3. So the throttle will still go up to 20 miles per hour and then stop. But you have pedal assist past that if you want, up to 28 miles per hour. And then you have California class 3 because they just decided to make their own rules. And so what that does is it's a true class 3 electric bike. It will disable the throttle, but you can still pedal up to 28 miles per hour. Next you have assistance level with a standard torque multiplier and an increased torque multiplier. Now this setting isn't necessarily new depending on what electric e-bike you're familiar with, but they just made it so much easier to change. This is one of the settings that if you're new to electric bikes, I'd recommend leaving it in standard until you get used to the electric bike. Now the increased torque multiplier is just going to give you additional power from the motor. Again, still in each pedal assist level, just gives you a little bit more oomph if you're looking for it, a more thrilling experience, if you will. Next is throttle slash PAS toggle. And when I say PAS, that just means pedal assist. This allows you to change whether you want the pedal assist or the throttle active or inactive. Another important one for those new riders out there is going to be throttle output. Now you can either have the throttle tied to each pedal assist level. This means in pedal assist level 1, you're just going to get a little bit of power and a lower top speed, all the way up to turbo where you'll get maximum power up to the top speed of 20 miles per hour. Or you can just de-restrict the throttle, so in any pedal assist level, you have full access to the motor. And the reason that I say you might want to leave this limited is because some people might not be ready for just how powerful this $999 e-bike is. Now there is a flip side to this, because if you have full access to the throttle, you can imagine me pulling up to a stoplight, I'm in pedal assist level 1, and I just want to get through the stoplight really fast. If I don't have the throttle limited, just hit the throttle and I'm going to zoom past the intersection and I don't need to change my pedal assist level. This might also be handy on hills, but it's certainly something that you need to be careful with, especially if you've never ridden an electric bike. But by all means, if you feel confident and you've graduated from throttle limited, check this setting out. Next also relates to throttle, and it's called throttle zero start. Again, another one that you might want to at least consider changing if you're new. What this does is it allows you to have access to the throttle from a standstill if you want it, or if you want to only have access to the throttle while you're moving, you can change it to that. Now you might be wondering why you might want to change this setting. Well, you can imagine people new to electric bikes, the throttle is going to be active as long as it's in a pedal assist level. So if you accidentally hit it, you're going to go if you're just hopping on your electric bike. So that's one of the reasons why it's nice to just be moving a little bit and then you have access to the throttle. Though in my stoplight example, again, it might be nice to have access to the throttle from a standstill. That's what most people prefer, but again, it's nice to have the setting. Next, you can customize the walk mode depending on your preference. And we have light mode settings if you want the light to be flashing when the lights are turned off. And then when you turn the lights on, they'll just operate how they normally do. Or you can leave it on manual mode where you just turn on or off the lights depending on if you want them on. Again, that's going to be done by holding pedal assist up. The last setting in the display is you can reset the odometer. I personally don't like this as an option, particularly for used bike sales, but it is an option. And so here are the things that you might not know. This bike has cruise control still. It's a little harder to activate because you need to be holding the throttle and pedal assist down at the same time. And because we now have a left-hand thumb throttle, that can be tricky to do with one hand, so be mindful and careful. There's now a USB-C port located beneath the display, 2 thumbs up from me. And here's the party trick, the display can be completely removed. Why is that important? Well, the display used to come shipped on these bikes, and in some cases they did arrive to customers cracked, which means Lectric needed to send out replacements. So now they're just going to ship it in separate packaging within the e-bike box. So you can just install it yourself, super easy with quick disconnects. And of course, if you're riding and you fall, I really hope that doesn't happen. Or if your bike is just sitting somewhere and it accidentally tips over and you crack your display, well, it's just going to be that much easier to replace. Simply slide off the display, undo the connector and plug in the new one. One hidden benefit to this that you might not have thought about is security. Say you live in an area where e-bike theft is a problem, you could literally just take off your display, disconnect it, and bring it inside with you, and no one's going to be able to turn the bike on. And while the display is easy to remove, it is one extra step when you go in somewhere. So maybe something you want to do or you don't want to do. Let me know what you think of that one down in the comment section. If you're planning to buy an electric e-bike, do me one huge favor, use our link in the description or scan the QR code on your screen before you make your purchase. It makes videos like this one possible. I want to help as many people get on electric bikes. So thank you so much for your support. And don't forget to check out our full review, and I'll be hanging out in the comment section to answer any questions. We'll see you in the next one.